The disease causes constant pain and prevents her from using most of her muscles. Because of that pain, she has decided this will be her last summer. She plans to stop using a ventilator that's keeping her alive, but only after celebrating her life.
Hello, my name is Richie from Social, steadily speeding past the appropriate age to be wearing more than one studded belt at the same time. So, a couple days ago, I was on the good old Facebooks, and I saw a kind of viral news piece, which normally I avoid them because they're really sad and depressing, but a lot of people were sharing it, a lot of people were talking about it, so I watched it. And it was a short piece on a girl named Jerrica Bolin, a 14-year-old girl with muscular dystrophy, essentially a genetic disease. There's nothing you can do to stop it or cure it, only slow it down and kind of numb the pain. Essentially, the disease eats your muscles till there's nothing left. And this poor girl had finally had enough. Most people with the disease don't even last as long as she currently has, but she's decided on her own to pull all her life support in a couple weeks because, you know, it's just no way to live. And I 100% support her decision. Obviously, there was a bunch of religious fanatic people on the video who did not, but you know, it's the internet. And overall, the story just kind of struck a chord with me. I noticed she said she didn't really have any friends, not because she's not likable. Spoiler alert, I met her. And she was amazing. She had a great personality. There's no reason why she wouldn't be able to make friends, but she's always in constant pain and under heavy medication, so she simply just couldn't get out because of her disability and make connections with people. So a couple days pass, and a bunch of the daughter moths, you know who you are, were sending me screen caps of a Facebook post that Jerrica had made, pretty much saying she wishes to meet kind of the people that she looks up to, and the list included a bunch of YouTubers and musicians, and wouldn't you know it, I was at the top of that list. She watches my videos, she really enjoys my work. So I got talking with her mother. We were kind of planning on doing a Skype call. I would just chat with her for a little bit, but she was actually planning on having a massive public event, which is kind of mimicking like a prom style, which is her send-off, and she wanted to Skype me during that event, which is when I had the idea. I'm like, you know what? What if I just flew out there and just surprised her, and that would be wonderful. That would kind of really make her night, or maybe the night after. I don't know. I'm not that impressive. So anyway, long story short, about 11 and a half hours before the massive event, I bought a plane ticket to Wisconsin from Washington, D.C., and I showed up, and this is what happened. Show me what I can't see when the spark in my eyes is gone. You got me on my knees, I'm your one man come. Cross my heart and hope to die. Promise you I'll never leave your side. Cause I'm telling you, you're all I need. I promise you, you're all I see. Cause I'm telling you, you're all I need. I'll never leave. So you can drag me through.
I saw you posted about me on Facebook and you wanted to Skype, and I was like, nah man, let's just bring it, let's make it real.
Please welcome to the microphone, Richie Geis.
Hello friends. Hello. Hello, Jerrica. Some of you might be wondering who I am and why I'm dressed like this. I have a YouTube channel and I sing, and I just found out a couple days ago that Jerrica really, really enjoys my channel, so I was really touched by her story, so I decided to come all the way out from Washington, D.C. last night to hang out with all of you guys and try to make this extra special. And honestly, I'm blown away with how many people. They told me there's going to be 200 people here, and there's easily 1,000 people here. The video that I watched with her, she said she didn't have any friends, but I don't believe that, man. There's like a zillion people here, so, you know, I really hope you have an amazing night, Jerrica.
Thank you, Richie!
So after all of it had concluded and everything was said and done, I had said goodbye to Jerrica. The whole thing was really emotional, and I just generally don't get that emotional over this kind of stuff, but man, it was a very emotional evening. And it kind of got me thinking. Normally, I know I make all these jokes like, you know, kill myself, drink bleach, it's all offensive, but it's all fun and games. And I normally don't like sugarcoating all my messages with the fake, like, you know, you're loved, blah, blah, blah. It's just, I don't do that. But just for this video, I want to say, value everything you have, value everyone you have in your life, value yourself, because there are people that have it 105 trillion times worse than you. And a sweet girl like Jerrica, who has done absolutely nothing wrong in this world, has to suffer for no reason, simply because her genetics aren't great, is just unfair. So cherish everything that you have. All right, well, I'm going to go lay in my bed for another 12 hours and think about things. Stay sad, but not too sad, all right? You hear me? And I'll talk to you guys later. Mwah.
Yay.